Oh, thanks. We're here at the sport club in Reseda. Trainer Tolik. He does strength and conditioning. He trains boxing. He worked with Sergey Lipinets before his big win on ESPN. Now his son, David Kaminsky, just 15 years old, five-time national champion, hopes to go to the Olympics in 2020 in Japan and represent Israel. He spars professionals. When I put up a picture of him on my Instagram at Ellie Segbeck, do you see all the comments you got?
Yep.
How many new followers did you get from that picture?
Like 45.
That's low. Usually it's like a few hundred.
Maybe
give it a couple
more,
days.
More, I don't know.
You know, about 15,000 people looked at that picture.
Really? I didn't see that. My phone is set up different. Like, it just shows the light.
Yeah. Here, I'll show people if they want to see it. But a lot of people who know you commented, say, hey, I know him. He's good. What is your son working on today?
Okay, we just finished boxing training.
Okay.
And we start today heavy power. Friday once a week we do heavy power. Today you just came on time. We just came for heavy power training. We're gonna do like 4 or 5 exercises, but heavy power for his age.
All right, so check it out. These are many people. Look at his picture. 11,000 people looked at it.
It's a lot.
It's a lot. Not bad.
11,000 just from yesterday.
Yeah. So check out, this is my Instagram. If you guys don't follow me, you can follow me if you want to. Come by, leave a comment. What do you need to do to work on power?
Now power training can do stuff from bench. So the bench is have big weight. You have 45, 45, and 10, so 55 on each side. It's 110 plus bar 45. It's 155 pounds. 155, this is basically his body weight, and he's going to live, he's supposed to live by 10, maybe 12 times, his body weight.
Totally, a lot of boxing trainers don't like weightlifting because it affects the fighter's weight, your muscle, or
yeah,
your shoulder.
Just explain me right now here, right?
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10,
that's it. Okay, one more. That's it. Okay, perfect. So, you rest now. So, power training, it's absolutely right. When you do power training before fight, like this start power training, heavy power, approximately 3 weeks before fight. Before 3 weeks, when we did fight, so we can do power training. We do once a week, like end of the week, once a week after all boxing training, definitely not before sparring. We do power training for 4 exercises, 5 exercises, basic exercise. So we don't do biceps, triceps, we just do chest, back, shoulder, forearm. That's it. That's basically that's it. Now we're going to do squat. We're going to do squat with back.
Tolik, is it a circuit, or does he do one thing, that's it?
No, it's do one thing, it's just single set.
That's it, single set.
Just one set.
Why one set? Why not three sets?
Because it's, no, let me explain. If you do, we do exercise like circle, like you do crew, it's Monday training. But now, every power training, heavy power, you can't do 3, 4, 5 sets. A muscle not gonna, on second set, he's not gonna lift it. It's super heavy. Now, just exercise legs. Squat, a little bit jump, and again squat. Again 10 times.
All right, there you have it, Tolik. Reseda Sports Club.
I bag approximately now, again, 150 pounds, approximately, and jump. Division of the And I want to show you now. I want to show you now. It's so funny. Sometimes I go to stores, and they have army store on Sherman Way in Topanga. Like army store, the store like located there maybe more than 40 years. And the store, I found in the store, it's
anger
for the boats. And the guy told me I have this anger like maybe 25 years, 30 years sitting in the store, nobody pay attention, nobody buy. I said, hold on, let me check. I took this anchor and I put weight. And I tell, okay, we're going to do 4 hours with this anchor. And now all boxers using and everybody think, oh, you bought this for, you know, for 4 hours. And everybody using it.
Show me how you use it really quick, Tolik.
Just 4 hours. You just use 4 hours.
That's it. So this I understand why it would help you as a boxer. Obviously you punch. So, right, no, but this helps you as a fighter.
Yeah, of course.
How does squatting, he was doing squatting.
Okay, it's a lot of people doesn't know. A lot of people doesn't know, but you have to be really educated and really professional to understand. Much as you have stronger legs, your hands is gonna be faster. We can see a lot of examples of Manny Pacquiao, stronger legs.
Yeah.
I mean, we're not talking about jumping and running. I mean, if you can jump, you have strong legs. I have stairs in the back, then jump 5 stairs. Explosive exercise. So strong leg, they make your hands go fast.
And the power comes from the hips.
And power comes from the legs. 75% successful boxing is come from your low body.
So if you have chicken legs, you're not going to be a good fighter?
No, never again, never.
Why are you laughing?
It's another thing. If you take, for example, Floyd.
Yes.
We take example, good example, Floyd. I believe the Floyd, I mean, it's amazing fighter, skills from A to Z, like more,
the best
of the best in the world, but his legs not that strong. You tell him himself, his legs not that strong. So he have talented guy, and he's like natural, he's different. So that's it.
What's next?
Forearm.
Forearm, yeah. We have one set forearm, now we have forearm.
Oh, I think it would be choke.
Yeah, you can do forearm too. Do forearm, you go right side and left side, so back and forth. So two ways. Forearm, you have to do two ways.
Counter clock and clock direction?
Yeah, in both directions. Now, this is a lot. This is 10 pounds plus anchor, so it's like approximately 20 pounds here. Yeah, approximately 20 pounds.
So that's half of the drill, and now you do the other way.
And now the
other way. Tolik, what else did you find in the military store? Landmines, security dogs?
Military store, just funny store for I have truck. My Jeep is 1948, so I buy that's outside. And I buy some stuff from the Jeep. From
a machine gun?
For World War II, this is, looks funny. Like, you know, looks nice.
That's cool.
This is super tough. This exercise super tough. And forearm.
Danny,
don't do that.
David, is it burn?
No, you squat, but you almost drop the door. No. Yeah, put that. Now one. You almost drop it. Put one.
It's one of the hardest exercises of form.
You make like this, and you almost drop it.
No, your dad has his own way. No trainer trains like this. Tolik, you learned everything. Learned everything in Russia, or you make it up like as you go along?
I make it up. A lot of things. Russia was long time ago, more than 26 years ago. Russia. Now it's everything changed.
Modern.
Russia, it was push. For me, Russia was push. Big push. Everything else, it became from United States, Israel.
You're from Odessa, right?
No, Lvov.
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 Where's that?
Lvov, it's west of Ukraine.
I knew Ukraine.
Yeah, west of Ukraine. Yeah. By the way, it's very good boxers from there.
Like who?
Oh, from Wolf, you have, probably you don't know this guy. He fought Alexander, Devon Alexander. His name, Andrei Kolesnikov. Kolesnikov. He fought Devon Alexander.
Andrei Kotelnik?
Kotelnik.
I know Kotelnik. He fought Paulie Malignaggi. He fought Americano. Yeah, so it's by Dmitry Salida.
Yeah, Kolesnikov somebody. Kotelnik.
Hey, Tolik, I'm like a broken clock. Twice a day, I'll be right.
Yeah.
Rest of the time, I don't know shit.
Yeah, Kotelnik is
I know, he's pretty good.
And it's a lot of good coaches from Lvov.
Yeah.
It's a lot of good coaches.
How far is it from Ackerman?
From where?
Where Lomachenko is from.
Oh, from Odessa. I mean, one night, I believe. Huh? Akerman is a small city close to Odessa, but it's
one day travel.
One night. Yeah.
You have to.
One day, one night. Train, I believe, train. But now it's fast train, it's probably a good thing. It's go probably less, probably 6 hours.
Boxing prospect David Kaminsky working on his shoulders. He just finished his boxing training. Five-time national champion. Hopes to go to the Olympics 2020 to represent Israel. He spars professionals. He just sparred Victor Postola, world champion WBC, who fought Terrence Crawford. He's working on explosive power today.
Another squat. And see, but almost two more exercises. We do this squat, this, and pull. That's it.
And you're done.
And we're done with heavy power. Heavy power, it's no more than 20 minutes. Heavy power is just 20 minutes workout. Otherwise, you just burn out yourself.
Should fighters take supplements, protein, shakes, vitamins, minerals?
It depends. You should take, I believe he takes everything, so every normal athlete is supposed to take some protein. We really recommend take, I don't have any sponsorship from any protein shakes, but we used animal protein. Animal protein is the best of the best of the market.
That's the best one.
The best
one. Rest fucked up your stomach?
Yeah, I mean, it's a lot of companies on the market today. It's really hard to tell, okay, they do this or they don't buy this one. But animal, for us, it's...
What animal?
Animal...
it's
animal
called animal whey protein.
Animal whey protein.
I think
best.
They only got one.
No, but I'm saying, is it made of animal products or is it just the name?
Animal products.
Yeah. What animal?
What animal? I don't know. It says animal.
Animal protein.
You have amino acids, you have protein, you have here probably have some protein. Vitamins, animals.
Right there. Right there. It's just like a traveling package.
Got it. And it does the trick.
Yeah.
Are you going to go into the weightlifting next?
No.
No. Hey, most of the people who lift heavy weights can't fight. They're just bodybuilders. They're not fighters.
Correct. Okay. This is three things. This is not two. Three different things. Bodybuilding, it's absolutely different language, it's different story, we don't talk about body. Powerlifting, it helps to boxing, again, depends how you're doing, what you're doing powerlifting. For example, bench press, it's powerlifting exercise. Deadlift, powerlifting exercise. Squat, powerlifting exercise. So it's probably closer to boxing. Bodybuilding, it's like, I don't tell, it's very dirty sport. A lot
steroids.
Of steroids, 100% steroids, and just for look.
I've seen them go to spar fighters. They look very intimidating, but they can't throw a punch and they gas out.
And it's getting tired super quick.
Yeah.
And
why? Because
his muscles just look big, but there's no cardio or nothing. Getting tired after 1 minute workout.
David, tell people where to follow you on Instagram.
Official David Kaminsky.
Official?
Official.
Official.
Apparently there's another one out there.
Official. How about you? Where do people follow you?
@Matthias_boxer.
Matthias underscore? Why underscore? Why not Matthias Boxer?
What did you say? Underscore?
It's different.
It's like a little line under.
Underscore?
Why are you underscore? No, it's like, it's a line. It's just a line.
Line. Reporting. What's this for, Tony?
This is for back.
Oh, okay.
Again, forearm and back. And it's a lot of weight.
I've never seen anyone hold it like that.
Yeah, he's very tall. And he switched
right now. Why not hold it?
Forearm, up and down, and he switched again in another side.
But Tolik, why not hold it with two hands this way and two hands this way? Why?
No, it's good for his back, first of all. So the back work on the counterclockwise and counterclockwise. So it's kind of return for the back, much better for the back, or make opposite grip. What else?
What's next?
Dips over there?
Dips and pull up, that's it. Dips with kettlebell 32 pounds.
35.
The kettlebell had name, you can read the name of the kettlebell.
Fuck off? Why?
It's okay. have another kettlebell. We can see another kettlebell. Right there, another one. We have another one.
Motherfucker.
That's a heavy one.
This is the heavy
one. That's a real motherfucker.
Hey, people don't know, but you had a fighter that his mouthpiece said, fuck you. And when I asked him why, because when the guy that came to make the mouthpiece, they asked him, what do you want? And he said, I don't know, fuck you. And yes. He put...
And he just did already, fuck you. But it's so funny, nobody does.
No.
I showed to Brandon Rios, he said, wow, I won't see him. I said, I can make it for you.
But then the ref didn't like it, right? In one fight, a ref said, I don't like it.
A ref said, no, in fact, he said, woo.
Yeah.
What's that?
Hey, would you get a mouthpiece, Christina? Christina. Yeah. She says, would you get a mouthpiece that says, fuck you on it?
Fuck you,
Elliot. No.
She's too cute to take you, to tell you, fuck you, you just can't do it, like, she's too cute to tell you.
That's how they talk in Russia, probably.
Yeah, Russia, it's everybody can tell you bad words, but...
Siberia.
Oh, Siberia, it's everybody talk shit there.
Yeah, it's too cold, you have to talk shit.
Too cold, yeah.
No, we're the nicest people.
Yeah, people, it's nice. Siberia, it's nice.
Like who, like Ruslan?
Yeah.
Like Kovalev? Ruslan?
Yeah.
Yevgeny's from, Yevgeny Gradovich is from Siberia.
Yevgeny Gradovich is from Tomsk. It's very close.
Gradovich from Belarus.
It's Tomsk
one. No, Gradovich?
Da.
I think Belarus.
No,
he's
from,
From Tomsk, yeah.
Yeah. Siberia, yeah.
Yeah,
he said he goes in a place where bears come in the street, in the middle of nowhere. Yeah. She says it's bullshit. He said that in the winter, the lake freezes and they use it as a road.
Oh, this is possible. Yeah, this is probably.
Well, Lomachenko's from the east, it has a hockey.
Hockey, yeah.
In Russia, even today, you have lakes, it's winter time.
Yeah.
The people play hockey over there.
That was over it's here, ice. But to drive a car, a bike.
It's pretty, it's 5 meter ice. It's
wow.
So cold.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekpak reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, @Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Eli Sekpak.